Greetings for the day. Welcome to another session of Cyber Law and Ethics. My name is Mohammad Rahmat Ali. So in today's session, we're going to study about the code of ethics and topics related to risk management in cyber security, or you can say cyber law. Now before starting today's topic, let me revise what are the things that we have studied in the previous session. In the previous session, we studied about the ethical aspect of management information system, or we studied about the components of information system with reference to ethical part. In that, we have seen the different things like privacy, we have seen copyrights, we have seen different things. So in today's session, we are going to see about the code of ethics. Like this is a general type of understanding between the people who are working in cyberspace, or the people who are into the cyberspace. They have a common code which is not been written anywhere, but there is a mutual type of a thing that should be among the people who are on cyberspace. So with reference to the 10 commandments that was been given to a prophet, the same way these are 10 codes of ethics. The first one says, "Thou shall not copy or use proprietary software for which you have not paid." The first and the foremost thing is with reference to avoidance of pirated things, avoidance of jailbreak type of applications and softwares. What are the things that you are using in cyberspace should be genuine, but because it will help you in both the ways. At first, you will not be facing any of the copyright issues, and the second one is nobody can access your information unauthentically, or unauthorized access of information will not be allowed. If at all if you are using jail code or jailbreak type of applications or pirated type of application, the risk to your system gets higher. The second one is, "Thou shall not use other people's computer resources without authorization or proper compensation." Like you are not allowed to use anyone's systems or anyone's access or anyone's thing to access your own particular information. I repeat that sharing of passwords, sharing of user IDs and sharing of other things is not allowed with reference to the code of ethics in cyberspace and with reference to the cyber law. For an best example, like the way you share your Netflix codes and Amazon and all this username password, that is not actually allowed with reference to the code of ethics. Third one is with reference to, "Thou shall not appropriate other people's intellect output." Okay, the next one is like, "Thou shall think about social consequences of the program you are writing or the system you are designing." This is very important. Like I'll tell you a small story with reference to this point. There was a person, a chief architect, who has designed an application for a bank. What he has done is when he was designing that particular application, he designed in such a way that for every of the transaction that happens through that bank, every of the transaction that happens, 0.01% will be credited to his account. 0.01% will be credited to his account. Like 0.01 or 0.1 also is not that big. Like if at all if you are transferring 100 rupees from one account to another account, only 1 paisa will be credited to his account. So in this way, within a short span of time, he became millionaire without doing anything. But when that particular application was to be upgraded, then at that instance, the other people saw that particular error and that person was then caught. So this is the thing that this point says. You should not write a program, or you should not design a system in such a way which shall harm the social aspect of the society. The next one is with reference, "Thou shall always use a computer in ways that ensure consideration and respect for your fellow humans." Like you should not be doing any of the cyberbullying or any of the rash comments which might hurt other sentiments. The next one is with reference to, thou shall not use computer to harm other people. And the next one is like, thou shall not interfere with other people's computer work. Like for example, you have been given a task. You have been given a task and you are not able to do the task. So what you are doing, you are copying your neighbor's or your friend's code. So this is not allowed, and this should not be allowed, because designing the same thing for a different clients might give a conflict of interest for that particular client, and you shall land in any of the problem with reference to this. So you should not interfere with other people's computer work. The next one is with reference to, thou shall not snoop around in other people's computer files. The same way, thou shall not use computer to steal. Like your system should not be working as a person, like you know, a system to steal other's information, or your system should not become a source of stealing the information from your computer or from your device. So it should not happen in either of the way. Like nobody should use your system to steal other's information, and nobody should use your computer to steal information from your device. The last one is with reference to, thou shall not use computer to bear false witnesses. Like you should not tamper the witnesses, you should not you should not manipulate the information, you should not manipulate the witnesses and all of things. So these are the basic codes of ethics with reference to the cyber law. This has not been written anywhere, but this is a common type of thing which should always be followed with one another. Now the next slide is with reference to the certification security analysis. At this particular slide, why I have included this particular slide is to encourage all of the students to do, like those who are interested in this particular subject called as cyber security, to do different certification courses with reference to getting a job, with reference to making your career in cyber security. There are different levels of cyber security jobs, and in the forth or future coming, there will be a lot of jobs with reference to cyber security and with reference to analysis, with reference to digital forensics. If at all, if any of you have any of an interest in this particular subject, you can, there are many of the people who are providing this particular certification courses and certification things. So I request every one of you to, you know, if at all if you have any of the interest, please do certification courses. And this certification courses is just to enter into the company. Rest is all of your ability to perform the task. There are many, a lot of people who don't have certification, but they are a brilliant type of analyst with reference to cyber security. And there are a lot of people holding certifications, but they are not able to do the basic task. So you should have both the things. You should have the ability to analyze the things, as well as you should have the certification. And there are a lot of certification. The basic certification is with reference to the certification in ethical hacking, and the way you grow up, there are cyber security analyst job, there are cyber security analysts, and there are disaster management team, and there are fraud detection team with reference to the forensics also. There are a lot of people, and there are a lot of jobs in the time to come in the future. So this will give you an opportunity, like, you know, if at all. And also I'll tell you, don't do the certification from any of the local things. Save money and do it from a reputed institution, so that the certificate have a value, and also the thing that you are learning will also have a value. Well, though it might be online or offline, but offer it so that it will be an helpful way to make your career in a correct way, with a full understanding of the subject. So what it says, certification will teach you fundamentals of cyber security and forensics, and will cover various areas in cyber crime, IT Act 2000, cyber offenses, wireless device cyber crime, phishing, key loggers, backdoors, SQL injections, distributed denial of services attack, identify threats, computer and wireless forensics, cyber terrorism, social media marketing, incident handling, and piracy. So these are the different areas in which you will be learning the cyber security methods, and you will be having an analyzer, like, you know, you will be an analyst. Now see, analyzing a particular thing doesn't come with reading of books. Analyzing is a skill of identifying the problem from the present situation, what it is. So the situation might be the same, but the conditions are different. So you should have an ability to analyze a problem in a correct direction, so that you may take appropriate steps, or else whole of the data will be subjected to risk and whole of the data will be subjected to breaching. So this is a very, you know, a crucial period or crucial thing that you all need to do. And there are a lot of jobs coming from European countries, American countries, or Australia. And now also, like, Turkey is also offering jobs with reference to the cyber security, and there is a big market available in the Gulf countries for cyber security experts and analysts. Now, moving forward, what is cyber risk management? What do you mean by cyber risk management? Now, cyber risk management is a process of identifying, analyzing, evaluating, and addressing your organization's cyber security threats. If at all, if you remember, we have seen the process of cyber security, or if at all, if you remember, I'll show you that particular slide. If at all it is available, then you will, I think, where it is. It was a process of, like, in the second unit, I guess, we have studied with reference to this particular thing. In the second unit, where we have seen the the process of cyber security management. Now, what actually it does? So it is a process of monitoring the information, analyzing, identifying, evaluating, and addressing your organization's cyber security threats. Now, the first and the foremost thing is with reference to the organization is to identify, analyze, evaluate, prioritize, treat, and monitor this particular method. So this is all about with reference to the security management. Also, it says the first part of any of the cyber risk management program is a cyber risk assessment. This will give you a snapshot of the threats that might compromise your organization's cyber security and how severe they are. Now, based on your organization risk appetite, your cyber risk management program then determines how to prioritize and respond to those risks. Now see, cyber risk management is all about safeguarding your particular organization or your particular system or your particular firm from external attacks, from any of the external attacks. So what you will be doing, you will be following this 5-6 steps with the method formula, so that it will help you in maintaining the security of the organization or the firm. The next one is with reference to the cyber risk management process. Although specific methods or methodologies vary, a risk management program typically follows these steps. There are 6-step method which is been involved here. The first one, or the first step, is identify the risk that might compromise your cyber security. Or this usually involves identifying cyber security vulnerabilities in your system and the threats that might exploit them. Like, I will not explain all these things. Like, these are the basic things that is there. If at all, if you have any of the things, that you can ping me. So the next one is with reference to the analyze the severity of each risk by assessing how likely it is to occur and how significant the impact might be if it does. The third one is with reference to evaluate how each risk fits within your risk appetite. Like, your predetermined levels of acceptable risk, like, for example, to which level of risk you can manage, or to which level of risk you can handle, or to the which level of risk your firm, your organization can bear up to. The next one is with reference to prioritizing the risk. Now, the fifth point is with reference to decide how to respond to each risk. There are generally four options. The first one is with reference to treat the risk, tolerate the risk, terminate the risk, or transfer the risk. So this is with reference to the how you deal with that particular risk. So now what is with reference to treating of the risk? Modify the likelihood or impact of risk, typically by implementing security controls. The next one is with reference to tolerating the risk. Make an active decision to retain the risk, example, because it falls within the established risk acceptance criteria. Now see, treating, tolerance, terminate and transfer is all with reference to the marks that you get. For an example, I'm telling you, if at all we are getting 20 out of 20, then no need to worry, like you are out of the danger zone. If at all we are getting 18 or 16, you will try to get, like, you know, you'll try, like, sir, can you increase one more marks or two marks? The second method. If at all we are getting 15-12 marks, then you will try to say, like, sir, please give me 16 or 15 marks so that my average will be a better goal. If at all we are getting 10 marks, then there is a low chance that we will be increasing marks. And if at all we are getting 1 or 2 marks, then it is totally unacceptable to increase the marks. So these are the different what you call as level of the marks that you are getting and how you are responding to them. They say with reference to the risk, they are these are the different methods: treat, tolerance, terminate and transfer with reference to the cyber things. The last one is with reference to, since cyber risk management is a continuous process, monitor your risk to measure or to make sure they are still acceptable. Review your control to make sure they are still fit for purpose and make changes as required. Remember that your risks are continuously changing as the cyber threat landscape evolves and your system and activities changes. See, the field of computer science and the field of information technology is such that what is there today will not be there tomorrow. It is not like, you know, other engineering, like civil, mechanical engineering and electrical engineering, wherein what is the thing that has been decided today will remain for at least for 1 year or 6 months or 2 years at least. But in IT, what is there today will not be there tomorrow. So you should be updated in such a way that what is the thing that is happening around you, you should be well aware of it, and you should have proper analysis method how to control that particular risk or how to control that particular thing. If at all it is a good thing also, you should be well aware of pro and cons of that particular thing, so that that particular application or that particular method or that particular instance cannot dilute your institution. Okay. Now further it says, what are the considerations for cyber security risk management is with reference to build a company culture, like having a good culture. The second one is with reference to the distribution of responsibilities among different people, so that people will only do that particular task. Only analyzer will analyze the things, cyber expert will monitor all of the cyber activities. Next one is with reference to train employees, like it is a good practice to train your employees from time to time so that they will be very much aware of the things. The next one is with reference to share information among the employees or share information among the different departments of an organization or a firm. Implement a cyber security framework. This is very important. Everyone should be well aware of what the cyber security framework is, like which website to be open, which website not to be open, which cookies to be accepted, which cookies not to be accepted, what is mean time that you are on a particular website. So these all of things should be defined with reference to the framework. Next one is with reference to prioritize cyber security risk and informing the employees and informing the firm people that what are the security measures and what are the security risks faced by the company with reference to the IT or with reference to in the cyberspace. Next one is with reference to encourage diverse views, emphasize speed. Like emphasize speed in the sense, if at all something happens or any cyber attack happens, there should be a quick response team to take an action. So with reference to that, it is said as emphasize speed. A quick response should be taken. Okay. The next one is with reference to develop a risk assessment process. The last one is with reference to incident response plan. With reference to incident response plan, we have seen in the previous slide, I guess, or in the previous unit or in the previous slides, we have seen with reference to incident response team. how they respond to the conditions. Now the next one is with reference to the risk identification. It says risk is a potential event expected or unanticipated that may adversely affect the institution's earning, capital or reputation. Risk is considered in terms of categories, one of which is operational risk. See, risk to yourself is in many ways. For example, if at all you are not submitting the assignment, then your marks will be cut. If at all you are not submitting the assignment in time, then also your marks will be cut. If at all if you are not writing the assignment correctly, then also your marks will be cut. If at all if you are not writing the examination, then also your marks will be cut. If at all if you are not writing a proper answer, then also your marks will be cut. There are different risks of getting full marks. So you need to identify all of this, which is the part which I need to work hard and which is the part which I need to concentrate on. So this is with reference to the risk identification. The next one is with reference to the risk management is a process of identifying risk, assessing risk and taking step to reduce risk to an acceptable level. What I have said you now, like to an acceptable level to getting 16, 17 or 18 marks, what are the things that you need to do? You need to work accordingly. Next one is says, organization use risk assessment, the first step in the risk management methodology, to determine the extent of potential threat, vulnerabilities and the risk associated with the IT system. So this is with reference to the risk identification. Now with reference to the controlling of risk, in addition to accepting risk, there are few ways to approach and treat risk in risk management. They includes, the first one is with reference to avoidance, transfer, mitigation and exploitation that we have seen in the previous slide. The same way will be avoid, like, you know, controlling the risk. What is with reference to the avoidance? The entailed changing plan to eliminate a risk. This strategy is good for risk that could potentially have significant impact on a business or project. Now the next one is with reference to the transfer, applicable to project with multiple parties, not frequently used, often include insurance, also known as risk sharing. Like, why you take insurances? Like, to transfer the risk, like to transfer the your particular risk on other people. So that, what are the thing, if at all some uneven thing happens, you will not be held responsible, or you will not to pay all of the things, the third party or the second party will pay all the things. So that is with reference to the transfer of risk. The next one is with reference to mitigation. Limited the impact of risk so that if a problem occurs, it will be easier to fix. This is the most common, also known as optimizing the risk or reducing or reduction of the risk. The last one is with reference to the exploitation. Some risks are good, such as if a product is so popular, there are enough staff to keep it with sales. Like I have told you, if at all there is a good application or a good thing, if at all it comes, like, you should be well aware of pros and cons of that particular thing. Though it might be good, like for example, like if you are using WhatsApp and other applications, your privacy is at stake. So you should be well aware of, though that application is good, though that application is popular, but there is something at stake. So you should be well aware of that particular thing. If at all, if you can take that particular risk, then you can continue with that application. Now the next one is with reference to, in such a case, the risk can be exploited by adding more sales staff. So this is with reference to controlling of the risk. I hope you understood something from today's session. If at all if you have any doubt, you can ping me at ramadan.com, or we particularly can have a doubt clarification session with reference to this particular thing. And also, this completes our third unit. So in the next session, we are going to start with the fourth unit. That's all for today. Thank you for listening. Have a great day. Have a great time. See you in the next session.